told you. The man said so himself.
It's a movie now, yes. But the movie's been televised. It's coming to us over the air like radio.
George Fulham, let me smell your breath.
Man is a curious, prying creature. Since the very beginning of history, he has been trying to peer into the obscure, creating the tools which permit him to snoop more successfully for his knowledge and pleasure. He wanted to find out about the stars and their movements, so he invented the telescope. He wanted to study the composition of materials, to see the germ in close-up, so he developed the microscope. He wanted to listen in on distant sounds, to pass along information. So he built more devices, the telephone, the telegraph, the radio. Without budging more than a few blocks, he wanted to see far-off places, distant people in action. So the motion picture camera made its appearance. But these were not enough, in spite of the fact that he could see and hear a duplication of something that had already happened elsewhere, a talking picture of a past event, in spite of the fact that in his own home, he could hear words, sound, and music from great distances the very moment they were being produced, still he was not satisfied. He wanted to go sightseeing at home. By his own fireside, he wanted to see as well as hear what is happening now someplace else. So, television was devised. Aside from broadcasting sound, television, you know, simply consists of taking pictures and sending those pictures out over the air at the same time. As you might expect, a camera is used for the photography, just as in any other kind of picture taking. Only there's no film in the television camera. Developing film and printing pictures takes too long. Besides, you can't broadcast paper pictures. You can, however, broadcast electrical pictures, and those are the kind that the television camera takes. Behind the lens of the camera is a special plate in a glass tube, one of the great developments in the promising science of electronics. This plate is a fascinating device. It's completely covered with millions of tiny electric eyes, which of course are sensitive to light. When light strikes them, they become charged with electricity, and the amount of electricity they develop depends upon the amount of light striking them. The more light, the greater the electric charge. Now, any scene is made up of various points of light and shadow. Some sections are light, some dark, some are in between. Here, for example, the jackets are lighter than the trousers, so naturally they create greater charges of electricity on the plate than the trousers do. All the shading and details of a scene are reproduced the same way. The electric eyes see the various differences in light levels and develop electric charges to match them. Combined, these charges form electric pictures of the scene, which are sent out immediately. Each picture does not go out all at once, however, as a snapshot might through the mail. Like a telegraph message, it's sent bit by bit, arriving at the receiver's piecemeal. The charge in each electric eye becomes an electric impulse and dashes merrily away by itself, the other impulses following in single file, one after the other. As they reach a receiver, they strike the screen in order and are transformed back into points of light and shadow. Of course, the process is much faster than you see it here. It has to be to keep you from noticing the mechanics of it, to keep up with any action in the scene, and to give the illusion of motion. We've just slowed it down so you could see how it's done. Now we'll speed it up. 30 complete pictures go out every second in the form of single electric impulses. And every second, 4 million impulses reach the receiver screen, one after the other.
Gosh!
It sounds unreasonable, I know, but it's quite true.